This is where America's first high-speed rail will be.
This is what it will feel like to ride.
And these are the workers building it. I set out to investigate the future of high-speed rail. Countries around the world with smaller economies than the U.S. have national high-speed rail networks, while the U.S. doesn't have a single route. But what I found was an industry in which big changes are taking place. I went to see the first high-speed rail project that will be completed in the U.S., figured out when you'll be able to ride it, and also asked, what took us so long?
Could something like this really happen?
And what do these projects mean for the workers actually building them?
This is Made in America with More Perfect Union, our look into ways the economy is changing that most people aren't aware of. And today, we're investigating the future of high-speed rail.
The first stop on my journey was Florida to ride a train that could give me a feel for what the future holds.
I just bought this ticket for $39, and I'm going to ride the route the whole way from here in Miami over to Orlando, Florida.
The first high-speed rail in the U.S., a train from Las Vegas to Los Angeles, will probably look a lot like the one I'm about to get on, because it's also being created by the same company, Brightline, that made this train back in 2018.
Sorry, I nailed you.
I'm so strong. Welcome to the train, everyone.
We're here in Miami Central. The train's also gonna make some stops in Fort Lauderdale, West Palm Beach, and then take us all the way to Orlando.
This train travels at a top speed of about 130 miles per hour.
And it feels pretty smooth until another train passes by you. And this train is fast, but technically it's not high-speed rail, which means speeds of at least 186 miles per hour. And that's something America has struggled to pull off.
But recently, several projects have been making some serious progress, and that's in large part thanks to unprecedented levels of federal funding. The bipartisan infrastructure law, which President Biden passed in 2021, allocated a record $66 billion for passenger rail projects. It's the biggest investment in passenger rail since Amtrak was first created in the 1970s. That money included the largest ever grant to California's massive high-speed rail line, which will go from Los Angeles, California, up to San Francisco and the Bay Area. It also included a $3 billion grant for what's shaping up to be the first completed high-speed rail project in the country, Brightline West.
On behalf of the Biden administration, it is my great honor to help break ground on what will be the first high-speed rail in American history.
I'm here in Las Vegas, where construction is starting today for Brightline West, a train that will carry passengers at speeds up to 200 miles per hour. It will go from here in Las Vegas to Rancho Cucamonga, just outside of Los Angeles. What excites you about working on a project like this one?
The stability of how long it's gonna go on. So I know I'll be waking up workers for the next 4 to 5 years.
This job at its peak will generate over thousands of good paying union jobs. The best part about that is this job has a project labor agreement that Brightline West and the building trades have entered.
When doling out federal funds for projects like Brightline West, the Biden administration has prioritized projects with strong labor standards. The project labor agreement between Brightline and the unions ensures that the company will employ union labor at every stage of the project. It also includes a requirement that 15% of labor hours go to union apprentices, workers getting paid to learn their trade for the first time.
Well, to us, it matters not just what's being built, but how it's being built. And part of that means engaging union labor to create good-paying union jobs. That's what's happening here. It's what's happening across the country. We've got provisions for local hire to encourage projects that hire people from the same area where it's being built. We've got support for PLAs, project labor agreements, that secure a higher standard, really, for what's going to happen. It helps the projects get done well. And, of course, it helps the workers and their families who are involved in it.
All that investment in the workforce could be a crucial part of building an entirely new American industry. It's possible workers trained on this project will go on to build high-speed rail lines in other parts of the country as well.
What I believe will be the legacy of today is this is really to mark the beginning of the high-speed rail industry. We have an automobile industry, we have
airplane industry, there's no reason the United States of America should not be the leader in the world for the high-speed rail industry. This can lead to literally millions of jobs. The new factories will be built here in the United States. All this will be done by union labor.
Brightline recently selected Siemens Mobility to manufacture its new high-speed rail train cars, the American Pioneer 220. The company will establish a new facility in the U.S. to build them to meet Buy America requirements in the bipartisan infrastructure law.
Buy America has been the law since 1933, but for too long, past administrations, Democrat and Republican, have fought to get around it. Not anymore. Tonight, I'm announcing new standards require all construction materials used in federal infrastructure projects to be made in America.
As construction gets underway, it's looking like you'll be able to ride Brightline West by 2028, and the first section of California's high-speed rail between Merced and Bakersfield is expected to have trains running by the early 2030s.
You know, so many Americans have that experience of going abroad, not just famously to a place like Japan, but, you know, to England or Spain or Morocco or Turkey, and they come back and say, why can't we have this? And of course, the answer is we can if we choose to invest in it. Once this is built, I think people will come back from family trips or weddings or whatever might bring them to Las Vegas. They'll go out to every corner of the U.S. saying, here's what I saw in Las Vegas. We should have this where I live. And we're already funding some of the research and planning in places like the Pacific Northwest, the South, the Midwest. There are so many parts of the U.S. that would be great candidates for great high-speed rail.
Through the bipartisan infrastructure law, the Biden administration has funded early design and planning efforts for a high-speed line between Portland, Seattle, and Vancouver, allocated billions of dollars to existing and new conventional rail projects, such as the planned higher-speed Raleigh to Richmond line. And in April, when meeting with Japanese Prime Minister Fumio Kishida, Biden discussed a plan to use Japanese bullet train technology for a high-speed line between Dallas and Houston.
Even this historic package, on its own, it's not enough to single-handedly deliver a national high-speed rail network, but it's delivering this and other projects that I think will make a future high-speed rail network almost inevitable in the United States of America.
There's still a long way to go for the U.S. to have high-speed rail infrastructure that rivals other developed countries. But I came away from my trips to Florida and Las Vegas feeling like I'd seen a new industry taking shape here. It's clear that smoother, more reliable transportation in the form of American-made high-speed rail is possible if our government invests in it.
Today answers the question that has been asked too often lately, the question whether America can still build massive, forward-looking engineering marvels that make people's lives better for generations. And this is just the start. I am firmly convinced that once the first customer buys that first ticket to ride true high-speed rail on American soil, there will be no going back. People will demand and expect this everywhere, and leaders will respond, and more high-speed rail lines are coming.
Thanks for watching. This story opened up my eyes to an entirely new industry taking shape, and we're going to be doing many more stories on the ways the economy is changing as a part of our new series, Made in America. So make sure to like, share, and subscribe to see the future episodes. And if you have an idea or a suggestion, drop them in the comments below.